Hi everyone, in today's video, we're going to talk about enums in Java. Enum is short for enumeration. So basically what we're going to talk about here is writing code that has a known set of enumerations and all of the constraints and programming you can do specifically with a known set of enumerations. Previously, before this was added to Java 5, there were other ways that programmers got around meaning to be able to program enum constants, and none of them really fit the mark. So the language designers added this enum concept later on in the language in Java 5, and it was a really good addition, and with some code, I hope to demonstrate why. Let's go ahead and open up IntelliJ and take a look. All right, so I've got a project open here. I called it enum demo, and I'm going to make a new Java class, and I'm going to go ahead and call it primary colors. But instead of calling it a class, I'm going to go and call it an enum. And you'll notice here that instead of saying public class primary colors, there's this new keyword called enum. And really all that an enum is it's a special type of class that has a few restrictions on what it can do and how it is interpreted. Really, what that enum keyword is it's some syntactic sugar. Under the hood, what's happening is the enum class here is actually a final class that extends the capital E enum class that comes with the Java lang package. So actually it's doing this. But I can't do that because the enum class within the Java lang package has a protected constructor. So long story short, the language designers added this enum keyword as a convenience, and in fact, actually it's a class, but for the purposes of writing your own code, you use that enum keyword. So really that enum keyword is what you want to use, and you use the capital E enum class for some convenience methods because it's actually the superclass of all enums. So to use an enum, the first thing you want to think about is why do I need to use an enum? The main case for an enum within your code is when you have a fixed set of constants that you know is never going to change. So some people would use the example of days of the week. Sometimes you might want to use prime numbers up to a certain number. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and use primary colors, as I mentioned here. So those are red, yellow, and blue. I'm going to add a semicolon here at the end. So you'll notice that I had this comma separated list of values, and all of them are uppercase. That's the typical convention among the community as far as how enums are formatted. Constants in general in Java, so like a public static final string, usually those are all caps. And similarly with an enum, because it's a constant, you want to capitalize them. The other thing that I like to do is I'm going to make these enums a little more complicated throughout the video. So I like to have a new line for each enum. Not everyone does that. That's a convention that I like because I think it makes them a little more readable as you start adding more onto them. But you also see people have them in a single line as well. All right, so now that we have some enum constants, let's go ahead and use them in our code. So in order to get an enum, what I do is I give the name of the enum. And normally you would think that you would do this, but the whole point of an enum is that you want to have a fixed set of constants. So if you want to have a fixed set of constants, why would you use the new operator in order to create a new instance? You're not creating new instances. You already have all the instances you need right here. So in fact, everything that is within an enum, you can assume has static context. So what you do is you use the dot operator, and now you can access the fields of the enum, which are actually static instances of this enum class, and you can access it like that. So now that I have my enum variable, what can I do with it? Let's start by just printing it out. Cool. So the toString implementation, which is called when you print an object reference, prints the name of the color here. Similarly, if you use the name method, you're going to get a very similar result. And you can see that it also prints the value of the color. Just to prove that that's working as expected, I'm going to go ahead and add this underscore here, and we'll run the code after I fix this. I should have done a refactor. That would have been easier, Will. What were you thinking? And as expected, the name method reflects the name of the constant. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and switch that back. All right, so another method that you can use is ordinal. Ordinal returns the index of the instance within the ordered list here of the enum instances. So this is going to return 0 for red. And similarly, if I change this over to yellow, now it's going to return 1. The ordinal method is something that you're probably not going to use very often in code. It is public and available from the enum, capital E, class. But really, in reality, the main use of ordinal is for some of the data structures that you can get out of enums. So let's show one of the data structures that we can get out of an enum. If I do primary colors dot values, and actually, the more I think on it, the more I want to refactor this name. I don't like the name primary colors. I like the name primary color. So let's go ahead and do for primary color, C within the values. What I can do is I can print out every single one. And if I comment out this line, I run the code, I can now get all of my enums. Cool. Now let's say that I have a string and I want to get the enum object out of the string. What I can do in order to make that happen is, let's say I have string value equals yellow. So what I can do is I can do primary color, color equals enum dot value of primary color dot class. And I already have the string there. And if I print out color, I get the enum I'm looking for. Excellent. There are two ways to do this. I'm gonna go ahead and comment out this first way. The other way you can do it is like this. And this will have the same result. Let's say that I change this to something that is not in my list of constants. I get an illegal argument and exception. And basically what that means is that the value here, this yellow, didn't map to one of my enums, so it threw an exception. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'll remove this first type. I'm going to get this back to where it would work again. So now because each enum here is actually a class, I can do additional things with each enum instance. So why don't I create a constructor? Primary color, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass in a variable, I'll call it darkness, and I'm going to have a variable called darkness in here as well, and I'm going to say this.darkness equals darkness. And now I have some errors here, and that's because I need to pass in values into my constructor. I'm going to say the darkness of red on a scale of 1 to 100. I'll go ahead and say that it's 60. Yellow is pretty light. I'm going to give it 20. And blue, I'm going to say is 50. So now if I wanted to, from a string, I can get my enum instance. And now I can do color.darkness. And I get the value 20. Cool. So one thing that I didn't really touch on is enums are really good at associating different things with known constants. And this concept of being able to look up an enum based on a string right here, this you'll see quite often in code, because let's say that you wanted to write out some data to a database. The database is going to have a lot of stuff encoded as strings. Sometimes if you're lucky, you can actually serialize your enums and deserialize them as well. But a lot of the times you might have to deal with strings. So if you want to map back your string into a known enum and then get some data associated out of it, this is some good code to be able to do that. Now, one really important thing is enums are expected to be constants, but I have an issue in my code right now. Because I am not encapsulating that darkness field properly, it is public and it's non-final. I can do this. This compiles. And it does what I don't want it to do, and it changes the value from underneath me. So there are a few ways to fix this. You can declare this value final, which is okay, because even though I'm not giving it a value right here, I know that by the time that my instance is done being constructed, that it does have a value, therefore this is legal code. And I get an error here again. So that looks good. The other thing that I could do is I could declare this private, and then I won't be able to access it here, and then I would have a getter for the darkness field. And then I can do like this. All right, that's better. You may think it's a little bit overkill to have both the final field and the getter. Kind of a personal preference thing. I like to do defensive coding. You might find folks who want to do just one or the other. It's kind of up to the coding convention or whoever you're working with. And if it's you working with yourself, then you figure out what you want to do. But I always err on the side of defensive coding unless I am realizing I'm being way overboard. One more thing that I do want to touch on, which is not used as often in code, but it is still something that's good to know, is I can create abstract methods within my enum class. Public abstract void. I'll just use a method called display. Now I've got an error here. Primary color must either be declared static or implement abstract methods. Okay, I'll just throw the abstract keyword here. But if you notice, I can't do that. And that's because enums by definition cannot be abstract. So that advice doesn't work. So now the next thing I have to do is I actually have to implement this abstract method. And the way I do that is within the bodies of each of these enums. So now I can say like that. And now this looks better. If I display what red is, this is the color red. I like red a lot. And then likewise, if I do the same thing for yellow and blue, so now that I've filled each of those out, what I can do now is I'll iterate over all my colors again. Then primary color dot values. Current color is C dot name. It is c.getDarkness units dark, and I have no idea what my units are. I'm just going to say that it's that level of darkness, and then I'm going to say c.display. And let's make sure everything looks good. We start with red. It's 60 units dark. I really like red. Yellow, 20 units dark. It's my least favorite. Blue, it's 50 units dark, and it's my favorite color of all. All right, cool. That did everything I was looking for, and it even gave you guys a little bit of insight on which colors I like better than others. And that's an overview of enums. I talked a little bit about why enums were introduced into the language, and I think they were a really valuable feature added, and you see them in code quite a bit. I talked about different use cases for why you would use certain enum methods, and why some may not be as useful as others. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, please do hit that like button. I really appreciate it. Thank you guys for watching today's video. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.